and welcome to the sold-out Phillips Arena in Hotlanta. It's a hot night as the Atlanta Dream, it's do or die.
Every game is important. This is our focus right now. It's one possession at a time. It's going to be a grind.
The Minnesota Lynx are on the brink of their first WNBA championship in franchise history.
I think we're all excited, but we're trying to just stay level-headed and know that we got to take care of business.
The Atlanta Dream 2-0, and they're riding the hot shooting of all-star guard Seimone Augustus.
We want to try to get it over with tonight, celebrate, you know, get on the plane tomorrow and go home to Minnesota and enjoy this.
Now for Atlanta, they've got a pretty good score of their own in Angel McCautry, a record 38-point game in game two, but both times the Dream have come up short, and now they're just one loss away from being swept in the finals for the second straight season.
It's do or die tonight. Pressure's on. Big.
Thing is, when you get on the road and you face adversity, you have to have the ability to get through it. And we control how long the series goes. We control it, right? I can see it in your eyes. Let's go have some fun.
I've been a longtime fan of women's basketball, and this is great. Just to see them perform, see how competitive they are, the tenacity, the skill, and the desire. I mean, it doesn't get any better than this.
From the very start, it was obvious that the change of venue did little to cool off Angel McCautry.
McCautry back the other way, pulls up the 18-footer on the way, good. McCautry got tripped up, fell to the floor. Harding will drive, drops it back for McCautry. She'll go up off the window, got it, and a foul.
And Cheryl Reeve of the Lynx had already seen too much.
Keep helping each other, rotate the rebounds, right? Here we go, let's go.
Our game,
let's go!
The renewed effort to defend turned into points at the other end.
Lindsay scoops it up, feeds it off to Maya Moore. Maya up the middle of the floor with a head of steam down the lane. The layup is good.
And methodically, Seimone Augustus began to find her way into the flow.
Seimone works the baseline, stops, jump hook falls. Seimone now with 6 on 3 of 6 shooting.
Sensing a shift, it was now Marinelle Metter's turn to rally her troops.
All right, let's get the momentum back. Okay, let's go.
Go! Off to Castro Marquez, looking for space. She drives down the lane, flips it up, and scores. McCautry against Augustus, up top. McCautry, nice little up and under move, throws it up from 15 and got it.
Angel continued to carry the load in the face of elimination and led the Dream to a 4-point lead at the break. With the crown in her sights, Seimone Augustus imposed her will as the Lynx forged ahead again.
You kidding me again? One way and back the other. Seimone Augustus does a nice little kiss off the glass.
Moore flying ahead of everyone.
Maya Moore, good in transition, nice finish.
With their lead cut to 1, Maya Moore snuffed the comeback bid.
Seimone with 3 on the shot clock. Moore's gonna let it fly. Buys it! That's a 3 big time shot, Maya Moore. This one is over. Let the celebration begin. The Minnesota Lynx are WNBA champions for 2011.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Oh my gosh, this feels amazing. It's number 2, but it feels just as good as number 1.
I'm so proud of you. Oh gosh, you deserve this.
This is the greatest moment of my basketball career. Right now.
It's been a long time, and I'm happy this day has come.
So this year's MVP is a unanimous choice.
This is a very bright moment. It's here. I think we've arrived as far as Minnesota is concerned. People are paying us some attention. Right now, we're celebrating this championship that we just, you know, earned and deserved.
Congratulations. You are the WNBA 2011 champs.